everybody, this is Tolki for another Shadowverse video. Today will be the fourth installment of Tournament Tuesday, and we will be taking a look at one of the games from the grand finals of the Rage Finals. The game was played between Salt and Kasago, two players who previously appeared in the Starfall Legends Rage Finals. So those two players have been at the top of the Shadowverse competitive scene for a long time. First, let's take a look at the deck lists. First, we have Salt with a pretty classic Havencraft Temple Summit deck. The most interesting point of his deck is that he's playing only two Summit Temple, and really is just a clean mid-range deck that is supposed to have game against almost everything. On the other side, we have Kasago with Spellboost Runecraft. This is an archetype that hasn't really been described as tier 1 in the past few months, but that does have its diehard fans. Spellboost just want to boost spells and to close game out with the use of Giant Chimera. It plays a lot of removal and is more akin to a control deck than anything else. So let's jump right into the game. Kasago is going first with Spellboost, and he gets a hand of Concentration, Sun and Moon, and Magic Missile. He decides to mulligan Magic Missile and Sun and Moon, and I feel like mulliganing Magic Missile in particular is pretty interesting, as it only costs 2 mana and draws you a card. It looks like he really wants to get Giant Chimera or other Spellboost cards in his hand very early to start spell boosting them as fast as possible. On the other side, Sol gets a very salty hand, and the two Blackened Scriptures as well as the Priest of the Cutgill definitely won't cut it against Spellboost. So he decides to mulligan everything. Both players end up with pretty bad hands actually, but Kasago sort of gets bailed out by drawing a Giant Chimera on turn 1. Both players set things up in the first few turns, and what's interesting is Kasago drawing a Conjure Golem on turn 2 and being able to dish out some early damage, while on the other side, Salt decides to not clear the Golem with a Blackened Scripture on turn 3 and decide to play a second Morlai Encomium. Then we cut back to Kasago's turn 4. And even though he dealt the 2 damage instantly, it then took him 90 seconds to play out the rest of his turn. So can you guess what he's thinking about? Kasago is thinking about casting the Nova Flare to get one more spell boost, as Nova Flare will likely rot in his hand for the rest of the match if he doesn't. It costs 4 mana and is not really a great card against Havencraft, and in the end, he decides to destroy his own Clay Golem because it's gonna die anyway to Havencraft Amulet next turn, and he gets one card out of his hand while spell boosting his Giant Chimera a bit more. This was one of the first advanced plays that Kasago displayed this match. And as we will see, even though Kasago drew pretty well, without the small plays, he would have likely lost the match. Salt deploys 2 Snow White on his turn 4. Deciding to not go for the Gemstone Carapace yet, while Kasago churns through his deck, and in the end decides to go for a Golem Assault and be patient with his Magic Ball, which he really wants to use to spellboost his Giant Chimera. Salt uses his turn 5 to finally play his Gemstone Carapace and his third Morale Encomium, and once again, he could have been a little bit more aggressive by playing Jeanne here, but he decides to take his time, and unfortunately, doesn't really put Kasago under much pressure. Then, Kasago's turn 6 is a pretty hard sequencing turn. He decides to start with the Concentration to see as many cards as possible first before spell boosting them with Magic Ball, then uses his Insight to go further in his deck. Not attacking here with it all means that if his opponent wants to go for Priest of the Cutgill or Blackened Scripture, he will need to attack with one of his Snow Whites and therefore lose 1 damage, which could matter in the long run. Salto uses both his Snow White to take care of the Magic Ball and deploys a very wide board thanks to either of the White Wing. As we know, he has Summit Temple in hand, and giving all his followers +0/+1 is really huge here. Even though Kasago is at 18, he could go down to 0 really fast. Salt also decides to pre-evolve his Aether of the White Wing, as here he really wants to have a sticky board and to be able to start pressuring his opponent from the next turn. Kasago's turn 7 is really interesting. He has many ways to clear the opponent board, but he decides to let the Aether of the White Wing live. He could kill it with a 0 mana Fury Embrace, but he wants to keep the Embrace for the Giant Chimera turn. Playing the Embrace the same turn as the Giant Chimera means you can clear a Heavenly Knight, which would be able to absorb 7 damage instead. So Kasago shows a lot of restraint, knowing his opponent cannot go for a hasty heavenly knight next turn, as he doesn't have any amulets, and Salt ends up having a pretty awkward turn 7, unable to play the heavenly knight he just drew, and being forced to cycle through his summit temples. Then Kasago draws a Mysterian Knowledge, and is a bit lucky, as he gets the Mysterian missile he really wanted here to handle the jam. So after thinking long and hard, he decides to play the Garden Golem and still not the Fiery Embrace. This is because his Giant Chimera here hits for 19 damage. It will become 20 with the Garden Golem, 21 with the Fiery Embrace, and his opponent is at 14. So if his opponent plays a Heavenly Knight, but Salt will have lost 3 toughness of the Aether of the White Wing on the Golem, which means 14 plus 5 plus 2 makes exactly 21, and this is what the Giant Chimera will hit for on turn 9. So this turn was really about thinking ahead, thinking about what the best play from your opponent would be. And Salt really wants to slam a Heavenly Knight now that he has a Summit Temple and go face. So here, the Garden Golem from Kasago is really a great bait. He knows he cannot die, and that if Salt takes the bait by killing the Golem with his Aether of the White Wing, he is dead. So we get to Salt turns 8, and he takes the bait. He could have gone a few other different ways about it. For example, cast a Black Inscriptor and a Pegasus de Halam, with the goal to go for turn 9 Heavenly Knight, as Kasago would be at 8. But here you just want to be slamming that Heavenly Knight. You want to be going face, really. This play by Kasago was really wonderful. Having slow rolled the Fiery Embrace for so many turns means Salt, like, nobody would play around it. Even a great player such as Salt here takes the bait, because Kasago hid his plan so well. So before showing my face once again, I'll show you Kasago's face when Salt decides to go for the Heavenly Knight, because it was great. And then Kasago untaps, plays his 0 mana Fiery Embrace, and kills Salt for exact damage. This game was really incredibly deep. I feel like Salt played really well, but Kasago still managed to outplay him by baiting this turn 8 Heavenly Knight. The lesson from today is, be patient when you're playing Spellboost. You have to map out your next few turns, because while the deck has a very strong late game, if it has a charged Giant Chimera, it's not as easy to play than just a normal mid-range deck. You don't have big storm followers and all that, and you will need to be killing your opponent pretty precisely to take the wins. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoy this fourth Tournament Tuesday. Next week we'll likely be taking a look at a Western match, as the NA Finals and the European Finals will take place. If you like this, I know it's getting a bit boring, but don't forget to like and subscribe. I've also started recently a one game a day video series. So I will be posting my first game of the day every single day on YouTube. And I still don't know what the theme of the video tomorrow will be. So I can just tell you, see you guys tomorrow and have a good day.